There's something wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes. What's wrong with the world today? We could go in so many different directions. Don't worry. It's going to be fun today. We are here on a Monday. I am so glad April Fool's weekend is behind us. I was tired of all the social media posts that were tricking me, making me try to go to Chick-fil-A on a Sunday. Chick-fil-A is never going to be open on a Sunday. But I'll tell you one thing that I learned this weekend that I wish was a joke. And this is what's wrong with the world today. No more cream cheese at Dunkin' locations. Yeah, I learned that today. I went in because I was trying to order on the app and it's no longer an option. And I went in, I was like, where's the cream cheese? Everyone's like, I don't know what? Cream cheese? I'm like, I just had it here like last week. No cream cheese? Butter? I'm like, no, it's cream cheese. I came up with this concoction that I really, really like. Here, let me show you a picture. I get an everything bagel, toasted, with cream cheese. I then order a side of snack and bacon. I bring it home, open that thing up. I gotta spread, you know, because they only put it on one side. I gotta take the cream cheese and put it on the other side too. And then I put the bacon on top. And it is a glorious breakfast. No more cream cheese. No more cream cheese. They did. They all acted like, well, I don't know what you're talking about. And I'm like, that dude back there would always do my bagel. He loaded up on the one half, but whatever. He's still, I know you, where are you going? But if no one has ordered a bagel from Dunkin' with cream cheese, they probably don't know what I'm talking about. But what they do is instead of spreading it out evenly on each side, they'll just bam, put it on the one side, take the half and smash it and be like, there's your bagel. It's like, that's, I'm not having a bagel sandwich. You know, I want the cream cheese on both sides. I don't know, maybe they got too many complaints about that. And this is a good way of zip, 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 just getting it out. But yeah, no more cream cheese at Dunkin' Donuts. Definitely distraught over this. Let's talk about Monday again. Setting up goals, knocking them down. I had a quote of the day that sort of sent me down a rabbit hole. Here it is. Positive obsession is a gift, not a behavior to be suppressed. I wanted to know who said it, so I Googled it.
Said you.
Unfortunately, I couldn't find the person to be quoted for that. But I did find a blog post from one of my most favorite authors, Austin Kleon. He did Steal Like an Artist. He did this one over here, Keep Going. I'll show you another one in a second. But Austin Kleon, 2 years ago, St. Paddy's Day 2021, he had a post called You Have to Be Obsessed. And in it, he writes about another author. Hopefully you're following along. Octavia E. Butler. And one of her essays is titled Positive Obsession. He quotes her as saying, obsession can be a useful tool if it's positive obsession. Okay, I'm following. Then within another essay about persistence from Butler, Kleon highlights the quote from her, forget talent. If you have it, fine, use it. If you don't have it, it doesn't matter, as habit is more dependable than inspiration. Continued learning is more dependable than talent. And I really like that. It's just get back at it. Set that goal, go for it, keep going. Keep going, Austin Kleon. I've these are the only two books that I have read of his and marked them all up. I have saved this one, Show Your Work, from him. Actually going on a trip soon. This is coming in the suitcase or on the flight, and I am definitely looking forward to drilling through this one. So, that's your babble. Everything I talk about is always put there. Let's get into this quote of the day. If you don't have a dream, there is no way to make one come true. Steven Tyler. I like how I bring that back around. He brought it back around. He is so clever. Hey, everybody. Enjoy the now. I'll be back at you on Friday with that new music. Ooh, 3-day fast. I'm pushing it. I'm pushing it a little later in the month. I'll explain. I'll explain why. You'll see why, too. But I'll be here sprinkling in some quotes of the day. But again, I'll see you again Friday for the new music. Make good choices. And as always, make it a good day.